Hello, welcome back to Andy and Autos Motorsport, part 8 of the Clio engine build. And in this episode, today, now, I'm going to show you how to install piston rings and how to install the piston. Now, because this is on camera, I'm going to be doing it with an old set of rings. Because, like in a previous episode, when I took the wrist pin clip out, it went ping and shut off. Things tend to happen on camera that don't tend to happen off camera. So I'm going to show you how to ring it with the old set of rings. Now, don't be alarmed. The old set of rings can't go back on because I've broken them. Remember? I specifically broke these when they were off to clean with. Now, I've ordered a new set from Renault. They are in a bag down there with all the other bits that I picked up today. And it hurt, really hurt. So, I'm gonna show you with an old set of rings, because on camera, if these break, I go, oh well. It's cold. If they break, I go, oh well, never mind. Whereas if the new one breaks, I go, oh god, they've got to come from France. So let's crack on, because these can be a bit of a nightmare and a bit of a git to do. So without further ado, let's crack on.
Piston
rings. Like I explained, when they come off, you have, in effect, 5 rings. You have the top ring, which is on these, a chrome one, and they normally do say on them, top. Ha 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 ha! Not that you can see it. I'm going to show you, but you can't see it. It's right there. Says C top. This one, by the way, you can't physically fit this one in the top land unless you're a complete ham-fisted baboon. Me. This one, they kind of go in there, sit in there, no real play. So this one says on it, I've lost it. Does say C top. So this is the top ring and the top bit goes towards the top. This is the second ring and it's got a little groove around the edge which is filled with carbon, and I'm gonna stab myself. There is a little groove and the groove points towards the top from memory. This Oh no, it doesn't. I'm lying. The groove points towards the bottom. This does also have C top written on it, right there. Groove points towards the bottom. Ignore what I said before. So, that one's your second ring. That one's the top. And this one is your 3-piece oil control ring. Ta-da! Now you have these two very thin rings, and one goes on the bottom, then your corrugated one, and then come here. No, there we go. One goes on the top. So these things bend, it's not an issue. These tend to crack. So what I'm gonna do, first things first, these little thin ones don't have a top and a bottom. They're like universal, doesn't matter. So, but first of all, just drop that down into there, pull that round the edge, ping, in you go. You got one ring in. Now, this, actually, as bad as it is, overlaps when shut. So what you would do, if this was any other engine in the world apart from this one, you would take this, go and fit it in the cylinder. So just pop that off. You go and fit it in the cylinder, get it flat, and measure this gap here. So it'll close up and you'll measure the gap, and when it's closed up, there should be a gap. On these, you can't, because you can't modify anything. So whatever it is from Renault is what it is. Which is where I've got a little bit of an issue, because if we had enough money, we'd go out and buy 20 sets of rings and size them all and grade them so we get the best ones we want. Is it going to make much of a difference? No. Is it going to make a difference? Yeah, little one. But never mind. They've done it to keep the cost down, and I understand that. So let's just drop this one back on, put that in, run the edges round. In she goes. Next one, which corrugated one, and that simply goes in there. It's a bit fiddly because you haven't got much room, and sometimes it's easier if you put the corrugated one on first, then you take this one. The corrugated one, when it lays in, does actually overlap, and normally only by one, but you can trim them down or you can just butt them up. This one again, it is there you go, that one's just sat perfectly in the top one for me. So this one, this one we're just going to try and drop in the bottom, shove it in there, just bring it round, drop it in the bottom. So now we've got our three-piece oil control ring. What I tend to do, what I prefer to do, is because you've got three brakes, you put one brake here, one brake here, and one brake here. Does it matter? Yeah. They're easy enough to move, so you can just move them around once you've done it, if that's what suits you. But you don't want holes lining up. So the gap in the rings there, you don't want one gap, especially these compression rings. You don't want gaps to line up, because it's an easy flow for gas to get past. And what's the point in putting new rings in if you're going to line them up and it's going to blow through? So, next one. Again, exactly the same. There is a tool for doing this. I don't like it. There we go. It's as simple as just grab the edge and just sort of peel it off. So you then just peel it back on. So let's say we have this one in between the two exhaust valve cutouts. Easy enough, flip the piston over, put that one on there, make sure it's sat in the land, run it round, drop it in. See, that went nice and easy. Now, you can see I've had these off before, because I'll just shove that one up there. It shouldn't have that much gap. That should be sat in kind of about there, but you can see I've been playing, and for my sake I'm just going to take them off again, because they're not the real ones, so they can disappear. D the tool that is available for this. I'm taking so much love and care and attention taking these off. Where's the hole? Where's the gap? There it is. The piston ring tool. Let me get this one out. There we go. Hey, it was right near the edge. Bye. Yeah. Still kind of. Got something in there. Now, I'm hoping you saw most of that because I just looked at the camera angle, but basically that this isn't them, this is just a pair of long nose pliers, but they've got basically a reverse pair of pliers, so as you squeeze them the ends open up, and they've got little hook like tabs on the end that you grab your piston ring, you put it in there, you squeeze them, and it opens the whole lot up, and you just slot it down, release it, and it closes up and goes where it should. Now, I don't like that. To me, you're putting a lot of stress on this tiny little ring that isn't designed to kind of do that, but they sell them, loads of people use them. Can't really say anything about that. So I'm now going to go off camera and I'm going to show you the new set of rings, actually, since they're here. This is how they turn up from Reynolds. So, they're done individually. I believe the price was $41.50 plus VAT at 20% for one box. Now, I think the total come to £199 and something pence for all four. So if you find these or a ring reno, okay, made in Portugal, if you ring reno and say, can I have some rings for a 172 or 182 Clio, and they go, yeah, it's £41, question that. Because what will happen is this will turn up, not this. It's £199.80, I think, for a set. And they come from France. They're not available in the UK because it's the UK. So let's just pop one of these open. Brand new in box. BNIB. And this is how they turn up, like a jumble sale. Tell you what I'm going to do. They're there. These are going to be scooped up and filed in there. So we have the two very thin ones. We have the corrugated one. We have the two compression rings, of which not that you're going to be able to see this, but I'll show you on this one. You've got best chance of this. This one says M top. I wonder if the C or the M is some sort of grading. Now, I've got the rings lined up next to each other. Like that. So these edges are lined up. You can see the difference in stretch. Top ring, second ring, oil control. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy, I can't make pie. So, I'm going to put them back in their little box. I don't know why, so I'm going to get them out in a second. And they're there. So, that's how to ring pistons. When I've rung them, put the rings on them, however you wish to say that, we're going to put them in the block. Now there's a reason I haven't fitted the rear main oil seal yet in part 7, yeah, and that's because I'm going to stand the block on its end to put the pistons in. Now the last thing I want is to put a brand new rear main oil seal in it, stand it on end and puncture it somehow. Now we're into more cost, more money, more time, more everything. So that's why I haven't put the rear main in. I can't put the front main on yet. I can put it in the housing, but I can't put it on the engine because the rod bolts haven't arrived. These bad boys haven't arrived. So I can't do them up to spec because they haven't arrived. So that means I can't put the plastic baffle tray on, I can't put the new oil pump on. Yeah, get a picture. Can't put the front main oil seal on. When they arrive, I can bolt the whole bottom end back up, put the seal in, turn it over so it's sat on its sump. That'll be easy, wouldn't it? They're being ordered Monday. Yeah. By the person who owns this. He, being a driver, gets certain discounts that I don't, so what's the point in me paying full price when he can get a discount? So I spoke to him last week and said order them, and hey, he was far too busy chasing his girlfriend round. So if it holds your engine build up, it holds your engine build up, not mine, mate. Yeah, so give me a moment and I'll show you how to throw them in a block. And again, we use a hammer for this. So I'll see you in a moment. I'm back, like I said it would be. Now we have piston. No shells are in. Again, make sure that these ends are clean. These have got little tiny pins in them so that you can't get the caps on the wrong way. Something you probably haven't seen before, piston ring compressor. Now I'm going to openly admit I don't like these. Put the piston in and basically you wild down on that and turn it the other way and tighten it right up and put it in and goes again there, and you tap this edge down, the top edge, so the bottom edge is nicely seated against the block, and then you knock the piston through. Now I don't like these for one reason, apart from they're a lot of work, they are also not good news. Hello. These things have a nasty tendency, when you're knocking the piston in, for a ring to pop out. Now it'll pop out between this edge and the block, and if you're not careful, you'll whack the top of the piston and it'll crack the ring and a bit of ring will fall out, and at that point you walk off, swear, might have a little cry in there somewhere, and then have to ring the suppliers and ask for another ring pack. Now it'll normally do it on the second ring, but sometimes does it on the top, and if you're unlucky to break two, yep, you guessed it, they'll both be the same ring. So, when you're putting these in, you don't put them in dry, you put them in wet. Now, you're all expecting me to grab this. Well, I'm going to grab this, but not for that reason. I'm going to grab some of this. Some lovely air tool oil. Now, as I've said in a previous video, that stuff burns off quite easily. Now, as you've got the piston, this is the oil control ring, and these are the compression rings. Well, when the squirter is squirting and there's oil all around the bores and the crank's whipping through it and smashing it up and it's going everywhere, this little oil control ring makes sure that it scrapes the bore and gets all the oil off, so this one and this one never actually sees any oil. These top two run dry. They're just there, kind of holding the compression up. Now, because these are brand new, you want these to bed in quickly. Otherwise, you'll polish the bores up and you'll have loads of issues with blow by and smoking and stuff like that. So, like I said in the previous video, that stuff burns off really quickly. So what we're going to do is we're going to throw the piston down. We're going to get our tool oil, and we're going to be quite generous with this because it's the only oil it's ever going to see. Now, just grab the rings, turn them, make sure it's all seated. Now, the final point, after I've lost my rag, again, there it is. Make sure that these compression rings are opposite each other. So they're opposite each other, we can see that. This one's got a little yellow tab, that one's got a little blue tab. Now's the time. So we're going to drop this over. And we're going to crank down on it, make sure our rings are going in the lands. And it's not doing like it just has. Wow. There we go, crushed. One more click, just for good luck. Now you can see I've left a little bit of the skirt out. And I've done that so that what I'm going to do now is I'm going to get some of my Happy Lube and come on, try and not pop the top off this time. Again, be generous. This one's number one. So this one goes to the very bottom where you can't see it very well. And I should have done this with number four, but this one goes this end. Now, I'm going to drop that in. What I'm actually going to do is I'm going to turn the crank so that the cylinder that I'm putting it in, the big end, is furthest away. So I'm going to drop that in, and that will fit in there lovely, like it was made to. Also make sure that you're putting the intake towards the intake side. Put it in like so. Take the persuader. and basically knock the edge down. Now taking this end, knock the piston in. Now I'm sorry I went quiet, but believe me, I don't like this. I hate these, but it's all I've got to hand for this size engine. It's a 82.7 mil piston, I believe. The other type you can get is a machined ring with a taper machined in it, obviously like that, and the bottom is the size of the piston. So basically you put it all in, and as you're pushing it through, it clamps it all up and slides it in. It's a lot more reliable, it's a lot safer, it's a lot easier to do. Easy equals less damage, less potential for damage. So now it's in. We're going to knock it all the way down. And I'll bring around this end on another one where you can see it. This top one probably. But now we've reached the bottom. Take the other cap, take the other half of it. And what we're going to do, because the actual bolts haven't arrived yet, is just nip it up. Now, if you don't mind ever so much, I'm going to turn the camera off. I don't like this. So I'm going to turn the camera off, and when I get to number 4 cam belt end, I'm going to bring the camera around the other side and show you from the other side what it looks like once the piston's dropped in. So when I get to that point, I'll catch you later. Right, number 4, watch this coming through. I might have to sort of jimmy the camera a little bit when I get round to doing it up, but I'll do my best. So, so how's the rocking camera? There we go. You can see I've just got onto it with my finger, holding it, coming in straight. And that's it, seated. I'm going to have to think of a nickname for the camera. Rocking around. Nope. Was it Status Quo that did rocking all over the world? I think it did. Rocking all over the world. There we go. Yeah, I'm going to get some abuse for that when this airs. Right. Main cap. Oh, there we go. Large camera stand. Put these bad boys in. See if I can get to the other side. I might just... There we go. Now, like I said, those bolts aren't staying in there. The mains are, but the big ends aren't. The big ends are going to be changed. And they're going to be changed to ARP bolts, which before anyone gets out their pram, it's in the regulations. It says we can use ARP bolts. It even gives you the part number and the people who run the series give you a 5% discount for them. So I'm going to let the driver go buy it. Probably get a better deal than me. Well, from them anyway. So if we buy it from them, they know it's been done. They know what's inside it. Excuse me. They're probably even going to see it on this video. But there we go. So I'm going to go and do the other two. If you like the video, please leave a like. If you like the content, please subscribe. Thank you very much for your time and for watching, and I'll see you again soon, no doubt with further parts of the Clio build. Once this is done, I'll just, yeah. Laters. Ciao.